Another type of quick pinless attachment will be shown in this episode. The attachment will use the inertia force instead of motors. You are going to see why some of the robot parts stop moving and some continue when the robot stops. On this robot, you can use the sensor shield to place the quick pinless attachment base. You can make it stick to it with these parts. For example, here and here. For the construction, you may need these parts. Like that. The same on the other side, and they need to be positioned like that. You can connect them with that part. And to make it a little bit durable, we'll place this part. Now, this is how it sticks to the robot. But it's not very hard. To make it better, you can make these connections here. And here. Like that. And that too. And here is the base. Now it's much more durable. The attachment that is going to be created will be for the Senior Solutions Chair Challenge Solving. The attachment needs to catch the chair in that way and bring it to the base. For that purpose, you may use two 15 pin holes beams and one 13 pin holes beam. You may connect them with that element like this, and here it is. And this is the attachment, but in that way it's not very safe. The chair may fall off the attachment. For that purpose, you may construct the same construction. And connect both elements in that way. You may use this kind of element. You may left the last holes for the adapter between the attachment and the base. Here, and it's ready, but as you see, it isn't stable. To make it a little bit stable, more stable, you may use this element, and now it's much more stable. Up to now, you have the quick pinless attachment base and the attachment. You need to construct the adapter. For the adapter, you may use these small axles here with that element. Like that. After that, you may use that small axle again, like that, and this part, like that, and one 3 units axle. With a cap. And you have to do the same to the other side. Like that. And here it is. That here. That axle from here. And that cap. Now everything is ready. But as you see, it's very hard to fail in that way. You have to speed up a lot the robot. So, you may use this part. You may attach it here. So, you can use it to make this construction more vertical. Now let's see how it works. Now this is what happened. While the robot moves, all of the part moves with it. Robot stops and the inertia forces come into play. The inertia drives the parts to continue moving forward. The parts that are rigidly connected to the robot also stop, but the upper part of the frame isn't rigidly connected, so it falls. Now you're going to see an example of how quickly we change the attachment. Try to use the same principle in your robots and leave us a comment below. Thank you.